Hi Vogue, I'm Emma Chamberlain, and this is everything I wear in a week. This is my everyday staple look. I wear this probably 4 times a week. I never get sick of it. I feel like you can do a lot with this, which is amazing because, again, I can wear it 4 times a week, but I can turn it into like 4 different outfits. I love adding this jacket, add a cute bag, add some glasses. It's just the perfect outfit. These are all of my like staple pieces. I'm wearing Levi's 501s, they're vintage. I have so many pairs of jeans. 90% of them are Levi's 501s. They're just the most comfortable, breathable jean that you can possibly wear. When I'm trying to find a good pair of 501s, the biggest thing for me is this area. I like the button fly to be long. I don't know how to explain it. It's like such a spiritual experience when I'm shopping for them that it's very hard to explain. I'm also wearing a white tank top. You can just throw them with anything and they look cute and sophisticated. I'm wearing this oversized leather jacket. This was actually something that somebody else bought and then it didn't fit them and then they gave it to me and now it's my favorite jacket. And it was free, which is the best scenario ever. When I'm wearing a kind of bland outfit like this, I like to match the bag with the glasses. And I love black frames with colored lenses. I think it looks very chic. This is a Van Gogh Louis Vuitton bag. I'm obsessed with it because my dad's an artist. This one's very special. My first fashion experience was with Louis Vuitton. It was crazy for me. I was like 17 or 18 and I had never been to a fashion show before. I don't think I fully even understood how cool and life-changing it was going to be. These are my favorite Doc Martens. I wear these again every day. Like this is really what I wear every day when I'm stumped. Getting dressed in the morning, I just put this on and call it a day. The thing I love about this is that every piece is just timeless. This is my event look. The dress is Alessandro Rich, the boots are Marc Jacobs, and the bag is Paco Rabanne. I love crazy bags like this because they're kind of like jewelry. I also love how it complements the shininess here. This is like my dream event look. I feel weird dressing up. It doesn't feel organic for me. I also hate wearing heels, and that's a big part about going to an event is that you have to wear heels, which is why if it's up to me, I wear crazy, chunky platform boots instead. That's my go-to event shoe. They're kind of a force of nature. I can't even explain them. Like they're like nothing I've ever seen before. I love them. I feel like they're me in a shoe, if I'm being honest. And when it comes to a dress, it's kind of a feel thing. Like I have to feel the energy of the dress. I love this one because it is kind of dainty, but it's balanced out by the edginess of the shoes. I really don't think there's a such thing as a dress that's too short. For me, the shorter the better, because I'm also not super tall. I'm 5'5", and things have to be short on me, or else I look like a little girl that got lost in her mom's closet and started trying on the dresses. So the shorter the dress, the better it looks. This is my work look. I probably wear this 90% of the time. This is proof. Like these are disgusting and terrifying. My slippers are trusty UGG slippers. I cannot tell you how many pairs of these that I've had. I wish I knew how many. It's probably around 10 to 15. I wear them to the grocery store. I wear them around the house. I wear them to take the trash out. I wear them during meetings. It's probably a little bit inappropriate, actually. My pants are aloe yoga. My top is Kijin, and it says career woman. I'm professional, because nothing says professional like a graphic tee. And then I have a Chamberlain coffee mug and my Warby Parker glasses. This really just takes me up a notch on Zoom calls. I refuse to wear sweatpants that aren't high-waisted. I also prefer to have a drawstring. Just kind of makes the sweatpants look cuter when you can tie them. I don't feel like I have to think about how I'm moving in an outfit like this because it's so comfortable and easy. But also it's still cute. Like I still feel cute in this, even though I'm comfortable. I feel like that's the key with loungewear. You don't have to choose loungewear that doesn't flatter you. You know, you can have fun with it and try to make it almost fashionable on its own. This is my vacation look. My platform flip-flops, these are Caperni. The skirt is Lewis Sanders. The top is Roj Hove. The bikini is 437. Glasses are like Sola. You're probably thinking right now, like, Emma, I cannot picture you wearing that on the beach, but I do have an explanation. When I go on vacation, I love to dress up. Ever since I was younger, I would go shopping and pick out extravagant outfits, and I felt like it was my time to kind of be a different person, because there's no chance I'm gonna see somebody from my math class on a beach in God knows where. So I have this room to explore. I pick out a full new wardrobe just for vacation, and it's when it has its big debut. These shoes are inspired by my mom, because my mom wore flip-flops exactly like this for probably 10 years of my life. I'm following in her footsteps, no pun intended. These ones are a little bit cooler than hers were. Sorry, Mom. I love you, Mom. I'm so sorry. But yours were not. They were cute, but just anyway. Honestly, I feel like this outfit is really a combination of everything I love about tropical vacation wear. This is my airport look. Matching bag and vest is Tega Akinola. Pants are Lululemon. Shoes are Vagabond. I cannot bear the thought of wearing jeans on the plane, which is why my go-to pant is yoga pants, always. Look at their efficiency. They are a little more fashion version of leggings. When I want to be a little cuter, I feel like the yoga pants are perfect middle ground. I mean, white sneakers are like obviously a closet staple for most people, I would feel like, but these are a little spicy because they're platform. To me, getting on a plane and flying somewhere is adventurous, and so is outdoors wear. You know what I'm saying? I don't, like, it makes sense in my brain. A lot of my outfit choices just make sense in my brain, and I just cross my fingers that I don't look stupid. But how can you look stupid when you have a matching bag? Are you kidding me? And that's my airport look. This is my date night dinner look. The top is Reed Dancy. The skirt is Unif. The bag is Louis Vuitton. It's a great size because it's comfortable to carry. It's not bulky, big, annoying. I don't like carrying big bags because I feel like they get in the way. And there's something so cute about a little dainty mini bag. When I'm going out, I like to kind of be a little more spicy, you know? That's why I'm wearing a skirt. I don't wear skirts a lot, but something about it feels right because it immediately takes my look from being like any day-to-day look to something a little bit more elevated. I feel like when you're wearing a black skirt, you can kind of have fun with the shoe. And I love crazy platform shoes. These are creepers. They're kind of underrated in my opinion. I remember the first time I wore them on my Instagram, a lot of people were like, Emma, we're not doing that. But I love them, and so I'm sticking by them. I also like wearing fun statement tops. Again, it's kind of like an easy way to make it look like you put a lot of effort in, when really you're just wearing like a simple top. I'm constantly trying to cheat my way into making it look like I put in more effort than I did. I feel like cropped shirts elongate my torso, which I find to be more flattering. I hate being overdressed. It makes me feel weird. And I feel like this is always my go-to when I can't figure it out. The black skirt has my back, always. The moral of the story is you cannot go wrong with a black skirt. This is my weekend brunch look. When it's the weekend, I wanna look cute, but I want everything to be loose. There's something about Sunday brunch that's very classy, kind of preppy even. I feel like I encapsulated that with this vest. This is like my preppy vest. I remember when I thrifted this, I freaked out. It's been like my staple favorite vest ever since. Obviously you need a little brunch bag. I love this. This bag is a sodom maze. If I'm being brutally honest, when I bring my bag around, I just put my keys in it and that's it. Because in a bag like this, like you can't really fit your phone in it. It's just to look cute at brunch. And I love sunglasses. This is perfect for brunch because you kind of can't recognize me. So if I see somebody I know and I look a little bit haggard from the weekend, as one does, I'm a little bit incognito, but still
chic a little bit.
Although, how chic can you be wearing Dickies? I don't know. Top half, kind of chic. Bottom half, a little grandpa, but like in a good way. What can I say? That's everything I wear in a week. Thank you for watching.